How to add a decal in Solidworks. Well, first of all, you've got to make sure that you have render tools showing up here. If you don't, you have to go up to the top icon here and go to add-ons and make sure photo view 360 is ticked on. Once you've that done, you can go to edit decal. Now we must have a decal that we want to place in here. You can see I've selected the front face of the object. So I've picked a well-known logo here. You can see the background is in it here. I've placed it into PowerPoint. And when I have it in PowerPoint here, I can remove the back image of it by selecting it and in color and setting it to transparent. I want to save that. I want to save it as a PNG file, and it's just because the PNG file can transfer into SolidWorks very effectively. It carries all the data with it. So I open it up here, select my image. You can see it does an unusual thing where it has the background blacked out, and I must change it to select the use a decal image alpha channel on that to remove that background on it. Now there's one thing that I've done here that I should have checked before that was when I entered in the image. I'll go through this process again. I didn't do any moving around of the image, which I can, so I need to show that. So I'll go to select decal alpha image after I've done my moving around here so I can resize it. You can see that when I pull it off the image, it only stays on that surface and it doesn't go around the curved surface. But using the toggles here, I can resize it and I can move it around on the surface that I've selected. I can also change the angle by that little circle here, and you can see the toggle bar moving around to the different degrees. I can take a little bit of playing with to get it back to its original setting, but I find that if you select that and you pull out the fill bar a little, a good distance, it's easier to get an accurate setting on it. So back to that. Set use decal image alpha channel, and you can see the background of the object is taken through. And just to highlight how it looks a little better, I'm going to apply an appearance finish on this. I'll pick car, which I think will be appropriate for this, and we pull in the appearance. Now one thing with the appearance is when you drag it into the object, you can see it gives us options whether I want to use it on the face or part, and there I picked the part, and there we have the decal entered into this. Now for the curved surface, I'm going to pick a different image. This time I'm actually going to pick insert a text box here. We can save text boxes as well as into a PNG file. So I'm going to pick a well-known brand or type of this brand and pick it to a decent size. I can bold, italic it, whatever. Pick any style of lettering that I want. And we need to save that as a PNG file. When I have that saved, obviously rename it. Open SolidWorks again. And we go to edit decal, pick the image, and this time the surface that I want to pick is the curved surface. You can see I have it, it's the same way as it was with the other surface. Now I can resize it, move it around, all that there, and this only this time I can actually pick to use the alpha image, and it still leaves me with the bars for moving around. And you can see once it goes off that curved surface again, you lose it. But there's loads of options for moving it around on the curved surface. It's just the way that it maps it onto this. But another thing I can do here is I can go to the mapping, I can pick projection, and I can pick cylindrical in this case because it's a cylinder. And it gives me slightly different options for moving it around. Probably more suited to the actual surface itself. So once I've moved that around to whatever way that I want it to appear, that I'm happy with, it leaves it then and I can render it. But there is one other option here as well. It's to do with references, so selected references, and it's to do with the position that the image is coming in at. I don't really bother too much with that, but it's an option there that maybe is useful at some stage. So I'm going with that, and I want to see what it looks like when it's going to be rendered in PhotoView 360. So I'm positioning it now where I'm going to take a shot of it to see what it looks like. I actually pick a render region. So resize that to what I want to look at. And I'll go with a preview window or a final render just to see what it looks like. And it comes out pretty good. It gives a nice image on the surface of the object here.